I'm interested in what made you give a shit. I said I'm interested in what made you give a shit. Like, when did your heart break? At what point did you break down and cry out, I can't take it anymore? Scream out, I want to leave the country. Or did you just want to leave the city? Did you want to leave the planet? Did you hear the last breath of a woman getting her throat slashed before you left? I guess that would depend on your location. Between Philadelphia and Chicago. Did you see those fireworks last night? We was watching up on a hill and I found myself thinking about war. And out of nowhere we were dead. Like 10 bullets traveling throughout the city, killing nothing but black people. A whole bunch of us at the same time, at different locations, sometimes through the heart, most times through the head. And I was 14 and she was 16 and he was 7 and he was 23. And the last thing we saw was fireworks. Symbolizing something. Can't tell the difference between America and the unknown that's forever expanding and reshaping the landscape. Collapsing the pole far away from any dreams and wishes you've been planning or hoping for yourself. You and your politics. And this class war will personally push the poor out of sight if you didn't let them kill us already. At this point, we are post-World War III. And everyone is dead or at home, deleting the human parts of themselves. Control, alt, delete. Control, alt, delete. Backspace, escape, 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 and I ain't coming back out again. Nah, I ain't coming back out again. Till they safe again. Today they moved every black body, not hanging from a tree, not in prison, not shucking and jiving in the house of appropriation. Out! But one thing for sure is people are dying with each blink of the eye. Did it break your heart when you learned he was only 7? Did it break you? Were you forever changed when she got chopped down with an axe by a man who said he was afraid? Are you afraid? Are you afraid? Are you distracted? Are you afraid? Are you afraid? Are you distracted? Are you distracted? We'll be right back. Upright. Upright, climbing, gripping. There's a way out if we could just hang on. Upright, climbing, gripping. There's a way out if we could just hang on. I'm talking about something else now. Nothing to do with death, that's a known thing around here. Cops are grim reapers, violence costs nothing, invades homes and homelands. All while mama's in the kitchen. Always in the kitchen in every dimension, thankful to give. Thankful to give, thankful to give, so eat up. I'm talking about something else now. You know, I bet they wish they could get their fruit back. Forgotten, left swinging from trees. And I hear mothers singing in the fields. Just gyrating and moaning. I'm not sure what they saying, but I'm sure it's something like, oh God! Oh God! Moses has been lynched, and the choir refuses to sing. Refuses to sing. But we need escape of hell coming, a redeeming hell, a hell sanctified, a hell that gets down on bended knees and teaches you how to pray before the fire. Before the fire, before the devil even enters the room. Painted fresh by Michelangelo, Jesus' favorite painter. Upright, climbing, gripping. There's a way out. There's a way out if we could just hang on. There's a way out. There's a way out if we could just hang on. Thank you. remember those times we were waiting for the bus and something hit us in the head and dragged us to the alley? Do you remember those times we was waiting for the bus and something hit us in the head and dragged us in the alley? Do you remember those times we were waiting for the bus and something hit us in the head and dragged us in the alley? The continual humiliation of a black woman's body. Remember? Remember, remember, remember. It happened again 2 days ago. Right here in Philadelphia. Before I went to sleep last night, I wrote down the number 23. The number of women killed so far this year by the police, and when I woke, 9 bodies were found, shot and killed. And a woman's throat was sliced while waiting for the bus. Does it matter who was doing the killing? Does it matter where the bodies turn up? Does it matter how many think they have the privilege and ownership and control of our bodies? At this point, we are under siege. And a compliment is a time bomb ticking. And being stopped by the police is a heart attack coming. And being alone at night is a game of Russian roulette. In New Orleans, they collect girls on the interstate as young as 22. In St. Louis, they shoot you right in your head in front of your children, always in front of your children. If they haven't learned to play dead yet. At what age do we teach our daughters to play dead? At what age do we tell them the monsters are real? She was 5 and knew how to play dead on the floor of a church. Even in the house of a white God, hell is only a mile away. Grandmothers doing the best they can, raising little black girls high above the eyes and hands of men. All them questions year after year, she can't be 16. Looking like that, she can't be. She can't be. Find me when you get older. Most don't make it past 16 looking like that. You can't be. You better be somebody else. You can't be. You better be somebody else. Around the corner, 3 kids were shot all under the age of 13. Around the corner, same time, around the corner, same time that something was happening in the basement. 30 minutes is all it took. The basement where so many go and leave no longer themselves. Well, our grandmothers are out daydreaming a better future for us. And they've been praying so long, somehow done prayed us back to 1920 against a holographic backdrop of a new empire skyscraping. And a backdrop of black presidents and popes waving goodbye on pedestals. And they waving goodbye because the end of the world has already happened. And every day somebody figures it out. And every day someone figures it out. Some get shot up during Bible study. Gunned down in the middle of the day on a bike riding to their aunt's house. Somehow they get hit by drunk drivers and left to die in the street. Some get their throat slashed by waiting at the bus stop. Does it matter if it happened in a week? it could happen. Does it matter? Thank you. not only do we disappear, 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 we hang ourselves and come up with other ways to find ourselves murdered. Since the Southern flag came down, ain't nothing except jails and burning churches. In all these cotton fields picked bare, lifetime of picking, we disappear. We continue to disappear right under the watchful eyes of those who rape us in jail cells at night. We disappear. And there's no justice in rehabilitation. No religion either. Just four pills in a paper cup called America. We continue to disappear. We decide right after breakfast. Soon as master rings the bell, see the sound sends us back to a time when death was a blessing sent from God. When you said by any means necessary, looking into your daughter's eye, that she was never gonna be no slave, no bandit's wife, no prison guard's bitch, no lynch body swinging to the tune of American justice. And sometimes you can get lost in the rhythm of oppression. I said sometimes you can get lost in the rhythm of oppression. The way they beat it into you. Carve trees in your back, choke you out. Fetishize your flesh. The way they make you fight for every inch of grace. We was just driving from Chicago to Texas. Drove right through the Dust Bowl, the Black Blizzard, all that promised land. Acres and acres and Homestead Act after Homestead Act. And the government is giving out free land to European immigrants. The land. They don't know how to hold the soil. They don't know how to cultivate the future. Must be all the memories from the dark ages. Stacked on top of each other. They are actively erasing your memory. So slow. They are actively erasing your memory. So slow, we forget that we ever demanded justice. And find ourselves at the dinner table of our own genocide. No one remembers Cincinnati or Toledo or Benton or Miami or Oakland or St. Petersburg. No one remembers. No one remembers 1964, 1837, 1919, 1776. No one remembers. No one remembers right now, or right now, or right now, or right now, or right now. No one remembers. Right now, or 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 right now. No one remembers Los Angeles or Crown Heights. Remembers right now, or right now, or right now. They are actively erasing your memory. Right now, or right now. No one remembers right now. Right now, right now, right now, right now, right now, right now. No one remembers. 1964, 1837, 1919, 1776. No one remembers. Freedom down the road if you could just hold your breath and get through the checkpoint, over the bridge, across the sea. How far do we go to get away from a hell that's always waiting? No one remembers. No one remembers right now, or right now, or right now. No one remembers. Chocolate City. No one remembers that the Funkadelic parked the mothership right here in DC. And what you gonna do if the president take a ride? Do it right in front of your eyes. What you gonna do? No one remembers. Right now. Right now. No one remembers. Right now. Right
Irreversible Entanglements. Just their homes on the drums. Luke Stewart on the bass. Aquiles Navarro on the trumpet. My name is Kier Nerringer. I play the saxophone. This is Kame Ayewa. Thank you.